Today we're going to talk about the F-35, probably one of the greatest fighters to have ever existed in the history of mankind. One that some people are going, it costs way too much money, but is it worth the price tag? Let's find out. How's it going, everybody? Welcome to FTD Facts. My name is Dave Wapple, and today, yes, we're talking about the F-35, the fighter that has it all. Now, before I get in this video, I just want to let you guys know that here on FTD Facts, every single Thursday and in this playlist down here, I always talk about new aircrafts from around the world. Well, not just new aircrafts. I could talk about old aircrafts, but more or less contemporary ones. So hit that subscribe button. Now, let's find out more about the F-35. So the F-35 obviously is a very controversial plane. Like I said, a lot of people are like, yo, it's a really expensive aircraft, but it's got stealth that is just amazing. Truth be told, its stealth is not as good as the B-2 bomber or the F-22. I'm sorry to say this, but it's just like the dumbed down version of those planes' stealth capabilities, but it's still amazing. As a matter of fact, some people already say that the stealth abilities of the F-35 has already been countered by countries like Russia and China. Most likely that has happened. It's not been confirmed, but even Israel was like, yeah, in a couple of years, this stealth technology is going to be pretty much useless. But however, nothing of that has been confirmed, so let's get into some of the actual facts about this aircraft. The F-35 was developed by Lockheed Martin, and I like to think of it as the little brother to the F-22. The first flight for this aircraft was on December 15th, 2005, but for development of this aircraft, it's begun as far back as 1992. And so far, the program cost of this entire fighter is around $1.5 trillion! Sort of. You gotta read the fine print on why it costs $1.5 trillion, because it hasn't really cost that much. Basically, your research, development, and testing and evaluation came in at $55.1 billion, and the procurement of at least 400 of these aircrafts. Currently, I think they only have about 380 of them out there in the real world. However, the cost for this came in at $319.5 billion, and military construction came to about $4.5 billion. So probably a lot of you guys are wondering, where is that $1,123 billion of that $1.5 trillion? Well, that is kind of maintenance for the next bunch of years. I think they say that's like how much it's going to cost until the year 2070. That's, of course, if they plan to have these planes till 2070. Like I said, if the stealth is already kind of going out, they might not. Now, the F-35 is a single-seat, kick-and-butt, fifth-generation fighter. And contrary to what most people believe, the F-35 has seen quite a bit of combat. Although a lot of this is really recent, on May 22, 2018, it was said that the first time it was used in combat was by the Israeli Air Forces in the Middle East. Now, this was confirmed by the Israeli Air Chief. However, he didn't state realistically when this happened, so there's no actual evidence to back it up. However, we know that the U.S. has used it as far back as September 27, 2018, and of course, there are other times the U.S. used it in the Middle East in 2019. And so far, its entire fleet has over 90,000 flight hours, so it has been used. So one of the biggest controversies is, yeah, a lot of people say, oh my God, it costs so much on the taxpayers. Yes, it did. But for all you US citizens out there, just to let you guys know, it wasn't just on you. Other countries from around the world also had to pay the research and development cost for this aircraft. So rule number one, love your neighbors, especially Canada, because we definitely helped you guys out with lowering the amount that was going to your taxpayers. Basically, countries like Canada and the UK and a bunch of others are a part of the F-35 program. Pretty much this means that these countries had to pay research and development costs because they intended to buy this aircraft. Canada right now is actually having a hard time figuring out whether or not it wants to buy the F-35. However, we still have to pay those costs. That was part of the initial agreement. I mean, like, we could totally say no, but, you know, like, it's not wise to, because we're all part of NATO. Now, the one thing about the F-35 is it has a really cool ability to do VTOL, or they call it SVTOL. Basically, what it is, it's an engine kind of similar to the Harrier jet, but this one can actually bend its engine downward and hover. It's really cool technology that is just for the F-35. The one thing is that a lot of people think that there is just one variant out there that is for the F-35. You know, it can hover and it can go straight. That's not necessarily the case. The F-35B is capable of actually doing VTOL and going straight, but not all versions can do this. For example, the F-35A, I mean, it has the ability to just do conventional takeoff. The thing with the F-35B is, although it can do this, I mean, it sacrifices, it's basically its fuel capacity for armaments and all that sort of jazz. For example, the F-35A has an internal 25mm autocannon, where the others need an external one added on top of it. At least that's from my understanding. Now, the F-35C is also one that has conventional aircraft takeoff, but the thing is, it's got foldable wings because it's meant for aircraft carriers. Now, the plane so far has three global factories in which it has 1,500 suppliers. These factories are in Fort Worth, Texas, Kamiri, Italy, and Nagoya, Japan. And the one thing that's really nice about the F-35 over the F-22 is because the F-35 has a more dumbed-down stealth ability, it's a little more friendly for exports and sales. Now, I'm also no expert on these fighters, but one thing that is really crazy with the F-35 is it has an insane computer system that is so advanced. F-16s are being loaded with a similar program that is being put into the F-35. However, one of the coolest things of the F-35 is the helmet. It has a major upgraded heads-up display ability inside of it. Also on top of that, the F-35 has six external cameras that are attached to this headset, so you basically could just like look around and see everything. It's pretty much like you'd be flying in an invisible plane. It's pretty much see-through. Now in today's world, like I said, there's over 380 of these aircrafts made. These are operated out of 17 air bases worldwide. Currently, there is about 790 pilots that have been trained in this aircraft, with about 7,200 people maintaining them. On top of that, there are 13 countries that are currently interested or have these aircrafts already. Unfortunately, Turkey is part of that 13, but recently it's, well, let's just be perfectly honest, the United States, because Turkey's been buying Russian air defense systems, they're like, no, we're not sure we're going to actually sell these aircrafts to you. Either way, guys, that is pretty much your basic rundown of the F-35. It's an amazing aircraft. I'm just curious, what are your thoughts on the F-35? Do you think it's an amazing aircraft? Let me know down there in the comment section below. And before you guys get out of here, don't forget to check out our playlist of other great, amazing aircrafts from around the world. I think you guys will really, really enjoy it. I got some good episodes coming up soon, too. So that means you got to hit the subscribe button. But you guys have yourself a fantastic one, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay? Bye. All right, so here's that playlist that I was telling you about. Feel free to check it out, but thank you guys for watching, and we will see you later. The F-35 just rocks, doesn't it?